Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am going to cover the concept of B-tree. Already I have covered the introduction of B-tree and the insertion operation, how to perform insert operation on B-tree in my previous videos. For your reference, I am providing you a shortcut link in this write-up corner. Before moving to the concept, I request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification of my new videos of my channel Tech Talks. Now let's start with the search operation in B-tree. Before moving to the search operation, I assume that all of you are knowing the concept of B-tree. If you are not knowing the concept of B-tree, please visit my previous videos in which I have already explained the introduction to B-tree, what is B-tree, why the name is given B-tree, how it is different from the binary tree, and what is the order of tree. All these things are very much important before going to the search operation. Along with all these things, you must know the insert operation also, because after insertion only you will be ready with the B tree on which you can perform the search operation. So now I am assuming that all of you are knowing the concept of B tree. So now here I am going to explain you what do you mean by searching in B tree. Searching, as usual, if I want to search any particular key value, then I can perform the search operation. The same thing I can do with the help of B-tree. What is the time complexity? Then the time complexity is big O log N. This time complexity is just same as of the binary search tree search operation. If you want to perform the search operation on BST, it also having the same time complexity, that is big O log N. And the B-tree is also having the same time complexity for the searching operation. Now here I am going to explain you the concept of the difference between binary search tree and B-tree. Binary search tree and the B-tree, I am going to explain you with the help of different parameters. Here the first parameter is, it starts the searching from the root node, and in the B tree as well it starts the searching from the root node itself. The next concept is, if I am having a binary search tree with me, then I need to take two-way decision. Two-way decision, it means what? We will be having two keys with us, and if I am having two keys with me, in that case I can perform the search operation in left subtree as well as in right subtree. At a time I can take a decision to go either to the left subtree or to the right subtree. But in case of B tree, I need to take M way decision, where M number of keys are present with me. That's why I need to take the M way decision. So now here, if n number of children are there, that is M ordered tree is with me, I need to take a decision M times where to go, with the first child, with second child, or third child, or mth child. So this only the difference between both the trees. After that, the next is the time complexity for both search operation is same, that is big O log N. So now here I would like to say that only the difference is, like here in binary search tree we need to take two-way decision, but in B tree I need to take M way decision, because M number of children are there. Let's move forward for the search operation. Now I am going to explain you the algorithm required for the search operation. So the first step is to read search key from a user. After reading the search key, I need to compare the search key with the first key value of the root node, because root is also can have more than one key value. So I will start with the first key value of the root node. After comparison, I need to check whether the match is, whether the key is matching with your current key value of the root node or not. If it is, then search is successful and we need to exit. But if the key is not matching, then I need to check whether the search key is smaller or greater than the current value or not. So if it is not matching, we need to move to the next step, that is either smaller or the key value is greater. From this I need to take a decision. So in the step number 5, I will decide if the search key is smaller, then I need to continue search process in the left subtree. But if the search key is greater or larger than the current key value, then I need to repeat the step 3 to 6. These steps I need to repeat again, where I need to perform the comparison again and I need to check again whether to go to the left subtree or to the right subtree and so on. So the last step is, if I am at the end of my tree. If I am at the end of my tree, it means that search is unsuccessful and I need to stop my searching by saying search is unsuccessful. Here I am going to explain you the example in which I am explaining you how to perform the searching of the number. Here this tree I am having with me, which is order of 6. Here the number of children are available maximum 6. Maximum children 6 can be available with my tree. Here I am explaining you the search operation with different keys. If I am having a first key like 14 with me and I want to search it in my tree, so what I'll do, I'll start with the root node, that is 16. Whether the 16 and 14 are equal, no, they are not equal, but 16 is, or the search key is less than or greater than the current value, so it is less than the current value. So what I'll do, I'll move to the left subtree. In the left subtree, again I'll start with the first key value present in my node. 14 is compared with 3, are they equal? No. Whether 14 is greater than 3? Yes. So I'll compare the next key value from my same node. And now here I will check whether 7 is equal to 14? No. Again I need to check whether it is less than or greater than. It is greater, that's why I will move to the next key value. Let's check whether my 14 is equal to 13 or not. No, it is not. So what I need to do? I need to move to the right subtree, because next key is not available in my tree. So I will move to the right sublist, this child of the node, and here I will compare the search key value with the first key present with the node, is nothing but 14. Are they equal? Yes, they are equal and my search is successful. Now let's move for the next example, where if I want to search for the number 18. So what I can do? 18 is compared with 16, it's not equal but greater, so move to the right subtree. Here I need to compare 18 with 20. Are they equal? No, but 18 is less than 20, so I'll move to this node where I will compare 18 with the first key value. Are they equal? No. So I'll move to the next key value present in my tree, present in my current node. Now 18 is compared with 18. Are they equal? No. Yes, they are equal. And if they are equal, my search is successful and I need to exit. Now let's move forward for another search where I want to search the next key value is 16. So if my 16, it is a root node, so here it is compared with the root itself and the search is successful. And now thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the content, please do comment, please do subscribe my channel Tech Talks and stay tuned with my channel. Here I am providing you the subscription link over here. Please subscribe my channel. Here I am providing you the next session of this video series and here I am providing you a playlist for the same. Thank you friends. Stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. Thank you.